save you. Can you see that? And to say that he was tempted in all points that we're tempted, don't say that. Well, I'm glad we can say that. I'm glad Paul says that. And that makes me to know that he knows the way we think. And after we come forth, we'll be as pure gold. He was tempted in all points that we're tempted. Any temptation that you encounter, you can say, Jesus, you encountered the same temptation. Now, just as you went through it, Jesus, you help me to get through this. He's our mediator.
Amen.
And therefore, he is just what we are here, so is he in the sense of being tempted.
By faith in this life. I'm trying to get straightened out in my mind the difference between the status of Paul's soul at the time he was getting ready to pass on to that of Jesus. I'm wondering if Paul didn't know more about what was going to happen to his soul at the moment he was getting ready to leave here than Jesus did.
Well, we have to say that Jesus had more knowledge than Paul had. Paul enjoyed the preparation provided by Jesus for him. That's it.
He
had what?
A doubt.
Not in the least. But Jesus in the garden, facing physical death to the soul and body, was manifested to us and wrote in his Bible to show to us that this thing called death to the soul is just too horrible for a fellow to invite it and want to take that route. The reason people want to take it sometimes is because they don't know that route. But Paul learned that route through revelation. And he understood that if his head was cut off, the head of the inner man wasn't cut off. It was under the outer man, and it was done for a purpose of making a way of his escape, an exodus, for him to move out, a way for him to pass out and go into glory with the rest of the brethren who had already gone. And that was a wonderful privilege, but Jesus didn't have that privilege. Jesus was dead, just the same as an animal was dead, and he knew nothing until he was resurrected. And it was just the same if he'd have been there for 6,000 years. 3 days didn't seem to have any quicker expired than 6,000 years. Because death takes all knowledge, all thought, and everything from it. And if you lay there for 1,000 years, it's just the same as today. Just the same as today.
Wasn't the bread of that period he was going to sleep as long as now? Wasn't the bread of him tonight?
Well,
there certainly must have been a reason for Jesus dreading death more than Paul. He had not.
Sure, there was a reason that Jesus dreaded death more than Paul. While both of them had perfect knowledge in regards to what was going to take place in their life. But Jesus was going to die the death of an animal. Not that, body and soul.
It wasn't the case with Paul.
It was not the case with Paul. Paul was going to move out. And Paul's death was just an exodus for a way for him to move out of this life. And Jesus' death was not to move out, but to go to the grave.
Brother Sowders, Jesus said if you destroy the temple, I will build it up.
worry about having help. He had the help already.
The word he spoke is the Father.
Right, sure.
Brother Stiles, him and his father knew the foundation of the world. He was the Lamb slain.
Yes, sir. Yeah, there was a son of counsel set in heaven before the world was ever, the earth was ever created. And in that council, their decision was that this Son of God, the first creation of God, was going to offer his life as a sacrifice for the redemption of men. And in that determined council, and the reason it was a determined council, what was said in that council, it was law. And they were determined that that thing was going to happen. Couldn't change it. It was determined. How's that? That's it. Well, the fire of God never dies because God is in. But he was likened unto an animal. He was the Lamb of God. And what an animal went through to save a Jew, Jesus went through to save you. Can you see that? And to say that he was tempted in all points that were tempted, don't say that. Well, I'm glad we can say that. I'm glad Paul says that. And that makes me to know that he knows the way we take. And after we come forth, we'll be as pure gold. He was tempted in all points that were tempted. Any temptation that you encounter, you can say, Jesus, you encountered the same temptation. Now, just as you went through it, Jesus, you helped me to get through this. He's our mediator.
Amen.
And therefore, he is just what we are here, so is he in the sense of being tempted. By faith in his life.
I'm trying to ask this question. I'm trying to get straightened out in my mind the difference between the status of Paul's soul at the time he was getting ready to pass on to the land of Jesus. I'm wondering if Paul didn't know more about what was going to happen to his soul at the moment he was getting ready to leave here than Jesus did. There was any difference. I don't know what I'm trying to ask.
There's
a point there
that
I'm trying to get.
Well, we have to say that Jesus had more knowledge than Paul had. Paul enjoyed the preparation provided by Jesus for him. That's it. They had what?
Any doubt.
Not in the least. But Jesus in the garden, facing physical death to the soul and body, was manifested to us and wrote in his Bible to show to us that this thing called death to the soul is just too horrible for a fellow to invite it and want to take that route. And the reason people want to take it sometimes is because they don't know that route. But Paul learned that route through our revelation. And he understood that if his head was cut off, the head of the inner man wasn't cut off. It was under the outer man, and it was done for a purpose of making a way of his escape, an exodus for him to move out, a way for him to pass out and go into glory with the rest of the brethren who had already gone. And that was a wonderful privilege, but Jesus didn't have that privilege. Jesus was dead, just the same as an animal was dead, and he knew nothing until he was resurrected.